Police in Angeles City in Pampanga take down a huge illegal drug operation. Over 100 kilos of methamphetamine, or what is locally known as shabu, were seized in two buy-bust operations. The haul is estimated to be worth over half a billion pesos. Police also arrested three suspects, two Chinese nationals and a Filipino. One of the Chinese suspects needed medical attention and was declared dead upon arrival at a hospital. Police have yet to announce the causes of death. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines backs a push to improve the country's tracking and navigation system, but CAP maintains it remains to be compliant with the required air travel procedures. It also notes all registered aircraft are undergoing the agency's strict inspection. Despite the recent crashes involving Cessna planes, CAP says suspending the use of such aircraft is unlikely.
Iba po kasi ang treatment sa commercial aircraft, ano? Unlike sa Air Force po, Philippine Air Force, pag isang model ang nagka-problema, lahat po yung grounded. Dito po sa issue ng ating Cessna, marami po kasi individual owner niyan at mostly mga flying school. Kaya hindi naman natin pwedeng basta nagkaroon ng issue sa isang Cessna operated by another company. Eh, kailangan hindi po pwedeng ipahintuin naman yung operations ng ibang aircraft. Dumadaan mo naman sa ano no sa stringent test at saka requirement ng mga registered aircraft dito sa atin. Unfortunately, marami yung factor kasi na nag-contribute kung ba't nagkakaroon ng crash. And mostly sa data namin is yung weather at saka pilot error.
Well, rescue teams have resumed their search for the four people on board a Cessna plane that crashed near the crater of Mayon volcano. Our very own Irene Perol now joins us with the latest. Irene, what more can you tell us?
Irmina, the missing Cessna plane, which took off from the Bicol International Airport in Dirgaalbay on Saturday morning, have been found yesterday. The wreckage was located approximately 350 meters from the crater of Mayon volcano but has yet to be reached. There has been no sightings yet of the four passengers of the airplane, which includes the pilot and his crew and the two Australian nationals, who are consultants of the Energy Development Corporation. At 4 o'clock this morning, 25 veteran mountaineers started the climb to the slopes of Mayon volcano onto the site where the plane was located. The path is difficult and the operation is extremely dangerous because of the current weather and the threat of the volcano, which is still on alert level 2. J.V. Añonuevo, one of the mountaineers, says they will be going traversely via the Miisi Channel, contrary to the path which was used by the rescuers yesterday. He says the place where the plane was located is sandy and rocky. Aerial searches are also scheduled today but have not yet started due to the inclement weather. The EDC is still hoping that they would be able to find the passengers alive but also understand the limitations of the rescue operation due to the dangerous situation. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Irene Perol there joining us on the line. Meanwhile, European parliamentarians will be visiting the Philippines later this month to hold dialogues on human rights. The European delegation will meet counterparts in the Senate and the House of Representatives. They will also speak with the agencies of the Executive Department. The visit will take place from February 22 until the 24th.